It's too late now. I remember everything and how careless we could be.
Yo, what's good everyone, Wolf here, and welcome back to the channel. In today's video we're back on the Infamous games. This time we're going to be playing Infamous Second Son, which is the first game where we don't play as Cole, but as a new conduit called Delson, who acquired his powers in a rescue mission that went wrong. I really enjoyed the story, new powers and mechanics added into Infamous Second Son. Also, throughout the events of Second Son's story, it starts to set us up for the story in the final game and introduces us to the protagonist, Abigail Fetch Walker, that we will be playing as in Infamous First Light, which is the game that comes just after this one and the final game in the series. Before we get into the Infamous Second Son bloopers and best moments, I quickly want to say a huge thank you for the support across my Infamous content I have released so far. I appreciate it a lot, and it always helps me to know which content you enjoy on the channel. If you do enjoy today's video, be sure to hit the like button. Also, consider subscribing if you're new to the channel, as we've got one more Infamous video to come out and plenty more content throughout 2024. Without further ado, let's get right into the Infamous Second Son bloopers and best moments.
If art is a crime, then just...
Damn it. Think, Delson, think.
Party at the Longhouse. Just gotta get there, mingle, establish an alibi. I'm a goddamn criminal mastermind.
Who's out there?
It's just me, Betty.
Delson.
Would you put the stapler down? Seriously.
What are you doing here? Why aren't you at the big to-do at the Longhouse?
I just didn't feel all that accomplished tonight, but you look amazing. It looks great on you. Seriously.
What were you doing up on the roof,
Nothing. Just...
Were you up to mischief?
Come on, I know you're in there, so just come on out, or I'll call Betty and she'll be here in 5 minutes with the keys.
You're up to mischief.
Okay, well, come on, seriously, what are you gonna do here?
Well, I have no choice. He's a cop. I have to be back here in 5 minutes, and if you are still here...
Thanks, Betty.
This is the last time. Now I have to go back to my office. Apparently, I'm getting a phone call.
Hello, freedom. And now the easy part. Get to the Longhouse, set up an alibi. Hey, man. I've been looking
like, forever for you. We should probably just get inside.
Do you have any idea how embarrassing it is for me to keep arresting my own brother over and over and over again?
Maybe you should stop arresting your brother over and over and over again.
You think this is a joke?
No, I don't.
Is this how you want to leave your mark on the world, huh? You think this would make our parents proud? Misdemeanor vandalism?
Listen, man, there's a lot of scary shit in the world, and while I'm out there actually trying to assert my talent...
You're trying
and cause...
to assert your talent? I mean, what
why
the hell
do
are you
always
even
do
talking
this,
about?
Reggie, why don't you just let
me
be who I
tell
am?
Tell me what big, bad,
if
scary
you would listen,
shit you're going
to
Sarah's
explain
brought.
It to
really?
You.
Because I don't seem to
Reggie,
get it. What?
Truck.
Thanks, man. I thought I was gonna die.
Are you all right?
Cop.
Hey, let him go! Just let him go and keep your hands where I can see him.
I don't want to hurt nobody. I just want to get going before she gets here.
I said let him go or I will shoot you.
Fresh?
No.
I said I don't want to hurt nobody.
Reg? What the hell's going on?
Oh, dear God.
No, no, no! Shit! I can't stop it, man. I can't stop it. Reggie, I can't stop
it,
man.
It's okay. You're okay. Just breathe. Breathe. You're all right. You're all right.
I'm one of them, man. I'm one of them.
No! No. You are my brother. All right? You are my brother.
Okay.
This thing with you is gonna pass. I promise we'll fix it. All right? You with me? You with me?
Okay.
Okay. You gotta get out there. There is a bioterror, so we gotta stop him before he gets to the rest of the tribe. All right?
Okay.
I need you. I need you right now.
Okay.
All right?
Okay.
Come on. You good?
Yeah,
let's go.
Not good!
Wow, that should have hurt.
Betty! Where are you? Betty!
Hold on, Betty!
Don't want to spoil the surprise.
Almost there, Betty!
You gotta get out of here, lady!
Stay away from
I'm
me!
I'm trying to help
no,
you, lady!
Stay away from me!
Stop!
Stop! Delson!
I was just trying to create a diversion. I didn't know anybody was in
you
here.
You did this to me!
You're a conduit?
Betty, I'll explain later, but you gotta get out of here now.
Good, I'm gone.
Not until you fix this first!
I spent most of my life behind bars. It's easy enough to bust out. You just gotta wait for that golden opportunity. When I got my powers, hell, I was unstoppable. Until the DUP caught up with me. Yeah, they got a special hole they like to toss folks like me in. Figured out a way to bind us all up so we couldn't use our powers. That also meant they had to feed us, wash us, even wipe our goddamn asses. That's no way for a man to live. There's no way. They had this red-headed bitch there, really into needles and scalpels. She called what she did to me tests. But if you do enough time, you learn a few tricks. You just gotta be patient. Sooner or later, they'll screw up. They always do. You maybe see something or you hear something. Learn things you weren't supposed to know. So when that bitch put the three of us in that wagon, I knew what was coming. A golden opportunity.
I saw you poking around inside my head.
It was me. I thought that was you.
You saw it, right? That DUP prison. If she catches you, that's where you're going. Wait! I'm warning you, kid. Back off!
You're not going anywhere until you fix this!
Listen! Just let me go! Just let me walk away! Nobody's ever gotta know about any of this! Wait a minute! Stop us talk about this!
Oh, Henry, I am so very disappointed in you.
Well, we got him, right? I flushed that mean old conduit for you. Good job, everybody. Especially you, guys.
Bioterrorist. Henry Daughtry was a bioterrorist. Conduit is a word used by traitors who sympathize with their cause. You're not a traitor, are you?
I try not to be.
You seem nervous.
No, I'm not nervous.
It's been my experience. There are only two reasons for people to be nervous. Either they're cowards, or they have something to hide.
Well, you know, I also get nervous around pretty girls.
You were in there with that bioterrorist for some time. Did he share anything with you?
Share...
Did he say anything to you? Share any of his ramblings about conspiracies?
No, he didn't share anything.
Good. That's good to hear. You see, we are engaged in a life and death war with these bioterrorists, and it's my job to do whatever it takes to ensure that we win that war.
What? That's kind of funny because aren't you a bioterrorist too? Okay.
Yes, I am. Sometimes you have to fight fire with fire. And it's clear now that you're not a coward, which means there's something that you're not telling me.
What are you doing?
You can't do this, you crazy! I've got rights!
And I have the legal authority to suspend those rights whenever I feel it's necessary. Like now, for instance. I'll ask again. What happened in there?
And I will tell you again.
I'm told that hurts.
Maybe I know what happened to there.
No, Betty, don't.
Really? Still nothing. Well, unless you decide that you do have something to tell me, I'll go chat with that nice old lady. But you should know, concrete is especially hard on brittle bones. And if she doesn't talk, I'll just move on to the next one, and the next, until I find someone who does. So do you have something you want to tell me? Or do you prefer that I move on to your friends here?
Thank you.
What?
I said I'm a conduit, all right? I caught it a second ago from that guy.
Oh, you caught it. Very funny.
Ah! God!
Telson! So, Betty, maybe you can give me a straight answer. Yeah, I'm told that hurts.
So what was the point of me turning myself in if she was just going to hurt her anyway? Like, I would have been better off just turning, fucking the tribe over, pretty much. And then letting them all have, like, a quick ending to this shit. Like, what? How's that fair?
Betty.
Delson, dear, you're awake.
So did Augustine do this to you?
Yeah, don't you think I was gonna rat you out to that ornery trot? Besides, at the time, it seemed like all the cool kids were getting their legs pierced.
So that means everyone here...
We're a Comish. We protect our own. No one here blames you for what happened.
Yeah.
Neither should you. Hey. Can't be ashamed for what you are. Can't help it. You were born that way.
All that matters is... I'm one of them now.
You are not one of those beady-eyed bioterrorists who go around killing people higgly-piggly. You're a good boy. Just happen to have smoke coming out of your fingers.
It's the whole reason why we're in this, is smoke coming out of my fingers.
Hey. Don't go down that road. If you're gonna be such a buzzkill, I'm gonna have to go back to sleep. Because I need my rest. So that I can get better and get on my feet again. And I can... rest now, because you're awake. Don't you worry. I'm gonna be fine. Really. Mm-hmm. You'll see.
Delson!
Whoa.
Damn it, I thought we were gonna lose you there.
A little concrete in the legs? It's gonna take more than that.
Oh, glad to see fast healing seems to be a part of your new, thing. Speaking of which, the craziness with the hands, is that gone yet?
I don't know, man. There's no smoking in the longhouse, remember?
Right.
And I wouldn't want to get in the way of anyone's recovery.
Recovery? Delson, these people aren't getting any better. They're dying, man.
You don't know that.
No, but the doctors who came through here when you were out, they do. And they said that... They said the only way those shards are coming out is the exact same way they went in.
What? Yeah. But that was Augustine and her concrete power. Screw it, man. Looks like you and me are going to Seattle and we're gonna go get her.
Whoa, wait. What? You think you're just gonna charm her into coming back here with you? Come on, man. I know you took a bump to the head, but you two didn't exactly hit it off last time you were together.
Reggie, I did this. And I gotta fix it.
No, damn it, Nelson. You just got back on your feet. Look, I know you want to help, but the doctors have already said
the only way it's getting out is with the same power. I get it.
Which means we don't actually need Augustine. We just need her power.
Okay, now you've lost me.
I'm a goddamn power sponge, remember? If I got smoke, why can't I get concrete?
Yeah, but what if smoke was just a fluke, huh? I mean, think about it. You'd have to go through, 1,000 DUP guys just to get to her?
Yeah, probably something like that. I'll explain in the truck.
What truck? I don't have a truck. That's my truck.
All right, I got this whole thing figured out, okay? We hit the town, we load up at the all-you-can-leech conduit power buffet, we maybe swing by the Space Needle, always wanted to see it, and then we're back home to save some lives.
You do realize when we hit the town, there's a fair chance the town's gonna, you know, head back?
What does that even mean?
It means that Seattle has 500,000 people that aren't exactly thrilled about the bioterrorists that are already there. You think they're going to welcome you?
No, but I'm going to be different, okay? Not there doing what they do. I'm there to save lives. I'm going to be like Superman. I'll be healing the sick.
The hero. What, you think they're going to throw you a parade? Wake up, man. Look, don't worry, Del, all right? We're going to fix this thing. I'm going to find you a cure.
A cure?
Shooting smoke out of your fingertips isn't exactly normal, man.
Just because it's not normal doesn't mean that it needs a cure, okay? Van Gogh wasn't normal. Gandhi wasn't normal.
Yeah, but people weren't scared of Gandhi, all right? People are afraid of bioterrorists. They're freaks.
See, that's pre-programmed bull... Shit.
Right.
Huh. Well... Looks like we're walking the rest of the way.
Walk? What?
Yeah.
Where are you going? Hey! Damn it.
Oh, this must be the mothership.
Jesus, Delson! Hey, are you okay?
Okay. I'm better than okay, man. I think I picked up a new trick. Yep. Yeah. Definitely new and improved.
Delson, this is not improved, man. We're trying to fix the problems you already have, not add new ones.
What do you think? Augustine is just sitting on her ass? I gotta power up if I'm gonna go toe-to-toe with Concrete Queen.
Hey, I'm hoping to avoid that. Listen, there might be another way that we can get to Augustine.
What other way?
I have a few connections in Seattle, right? Some in the police force.
No. This is not the point where Reggie swoops in and makes everything all right. This is not your problem to fix. It is mine.
Oh, is somebody there? Can you hear me?
There. Perfect. You want to go help somebody? Go save damsel in distress.
Anyone? That's not...
Right. Fine. We both go. Come
on. No. Play Super Cop, okay? I will catch up with you in a minute.
All right, but don't go anywhere. And for God's sake, don't touch anything!
I'm gonna touch everything. Hello.
Reggie, open up. Let's go.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me.
Hello?
Hey, Delson, we got a problem. Some of the people on the bus, they saw you doing your super thingy to clear the way.
And
they're afraid of you.
What?
Look, I told you, man. Bioterrorists aren't especially popular.
What am I, like Rosa Parks, and they want me to sit on the back of the bus?
No, they want you to sit outside the bus. Look, they don't want you in here, right? They said if you come on, they're gonna get off.
Then let them walk. I don't care. You think I can't take this door down?
You are not gonna do that. These people have never seen anything like you before, and they're scared, right? And I can't blame them.
He says he's gonna break down the door. Go!
Sir! Just give me a second! Look, just let me run them across the bridge. I'll come right back for you, all right? It'll take 5 minutes. Come on, man. I can't let you on the bus. 5 minutes.
The bus. Reggie!
Little help here.
That's that pitching arm again, huh?
Delson!
All right, come on.
I got it. Thanks for the hand.
Check it out.
Wow. Seem to be getting the hang of your new symptoms.
Right? And of course, the only downside being that... Nope. Can't think of anything. This is pretty freaking awesome.
Really? No downside? How about those heavily armed guys over there now want to hurt you real bad? That a downside? Yeah. Now look. For all we know, we may be able to pass you through their security, you know, because you're not a normal bioterrorist.
So normal? No, if you mean by normal, you know, the sheep that they try to line up so that they can probe them. No, Reggie, I'm not normal. And did you see what I did on that bridge? We could take these guys.
Let's just see if we can sneak you through their checkpoints first, all right? It'll make getting around the city a lot easier.
Okay, fine. We'll do it your way. I'll settle. Brother wants me to fight the ultra mega bioterrorist of all time with less powers.
Look, I didn't say that.
Oh well, shit, I messed up badly there. Gone flying.
Go straight on. Wow. Not sure a closet can hold a conduit for long, but I appreciate your wanting to lock me up.
That guy just fell off. Fuck, say, looks like two of them's done it.
Right.
I doubt the DUP is gonna let you borrow their keys. You're probably gonna have to break them.
Oh, open. Cheers for that one, mate. Have that, mate.
Not bad, huh? You want to see it again? This ink is away.
Hello, Science Center District. I lost you. Did you read me? I'm getting nothing, sir. You? Nothing outside our immediate area.
Yeah, Reg. Let's go find us some prime conduits and get some new powers. We own the streets!
Take it easy. A few streets in the immediate vicinity, all right? The DUP still owns the other 98%.
But we kicked them off the Space Needle, man!
You knocked out their comm center, okay? They may be deaf, but they're not dumb. Kicking the DUP completely out of Seattle is gonna take time. We just got here.
You know what they say. The journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single kick-ass tag.
Who says that?
The Chinese people. Hey, Reg. You see it from down there?
Kidding? People in Portland can see it.
I just want to let the dupes know I'm here, man.
What the hell is that? That's not one of the three who escaped.
I think this is a really cool feature of the game. Like, you turn your controller sideways, shake it, and it rattles the can. It's a bit tricky to get it to line up sometimes, but then you start spray painting it. Like, I think this is a really good feature. And then you do the different layers. Obviously, I'm struggling here a bit to get my controller to line it up. I hadn't even completed that one, but the game was like, yeah, you've done that apparently. Then you go on to your next layer. Make sure I get everything. And I think it's 3 layers total you spray, and then you get your whole graffiti tag. And you get to choose, like, good or bad, like, one that you want to spray as well. So it helps with, like, your karma levels. Oh, that one was only 2. I done one earlier, and it was 3 sprays. But yeah, you then get just a little bit of graffiti done. I think that's a really cool feature to add into the game. It's a cool way to use your controller as well. You what? Ain't fucking saying it now, are you, mate? Hold that, lads.
Holy!
The fuck was that?
Holy what? Like lasers or something. I'm telling you, it would be great to have a 1-2 punch like that and smoke when I get to Augustine.
Take it easy. We've got to find him again first.
I see what they've done here, Lincoln's tow truck. So I was literally about to say, why is this truck a big, like, foot? That's a play on words, because a tow truck. Fuck's sake.
Well, one thing this place tells us is that our sniper is a sniperette.
Wait, what?
You should see this, Reg. It's like the girliest sniper's nest you've ever seen.
What does that even mean?
I don't know, it's just girled up, girl stuff, like the name Brent burned into the wall in girly handwriting, and it is definitely the best-smelling assassin's den you could ever be in.
Okay, look, just send me photos of anything you think might help.
Well, that's one way to do it, I suppose. Take them all out of one rocket.
I take some cash off those dealers. Money, why do you hate me? Be my friend, Money. Come to me. Let's bond. No!
It's okay. God.
Lady, you've got to calm down, all right? Just relax.
You're not taking me back! I am not going back to Curtin Cage! No, no, no!
As a little girl, I never thought it'd be me. That I'd be one of them. My powers were a surprise. My parents turned me in. They knew what the government would do to people like me, and they did it anyway. I didn't know what to do, but my brother Brent just grabbed our coats, and we ran. Those were hard days on the street. Moving from city to city, no comfort anywhere. Until we met some dealers, and man, they hooked us up. The drugs were heaven. But then we always wanted more. And the withdrawal, agony. Always looking for a fix. And when you lose your stash, when you think someone stole it from you, the drugs, the dealers, they make you do things they... Oh, God, Brent. The government picked me up easy enough after that. But it wasn't a regular jail. They trained me to shoot, taught me how to kill. on the day of the crash. I escaped with all those skills. Everything I needed to set things right. Brent, I promise. Every dealer I find, I'm gonna burn your name in their chest. No one else is gonna suffer like we did. No, brother. Nobody else.
Hey, Delson, you all right, brother?
What happened?
Oh, you did good. You did good, buddy. Come on, get up. Get up. Oh, jump. Hey, you did good. I know just where to put filth like this. Somewhere where Augustine won't find her, and she won't be hurting anybody else.
Hey, no. She's just killing drug dealers, man.
Killing? Delson, murdering drug dealers.
What do you think I'm doing to the DUP?
What you have to save the Okomish back home.
She stays free.
No. Dude, no way. Look, just because you have the same affliction, not gift, affliction, doesn't mean that we're gonna pick up every little piece of trash we find. Look, I'm never going to abandon you, all right? Not ever. This one goes in a cage. Hey!
Conduits. It's my call. Not yours, not ours, mine.
Really? So Mr. Freewheeling Badass finally wants to take on some responsibility. And for what, huh? A bioterrorist with a body count?
I love you, Reg. Don't make me break that handsome nose of yours.
Why? If she kills someone's father tomorrow, or mother the day after that, you're the one that allowed that to happen.
Now calm down.
Yeah. Let's talk.
Yeah.
Okay, there's supposed to be one of those things at 2nd and Main.
Yeah, I've seen it before. Meet you there.
Oh, it's going straight through the map. How the fuck have I done that then? Well, damn. What a power.
Whatever that was, I heard it from here.
What's up?
Looks like the haters are getting ready for their big parade. You in?
Oh, I'm in. I'm a total hater.
Dee, hey, I see you following my signs.
Oh yeah, real subtle.
Listen, there's about a million dupes right outside the tunnel in front of you, so...
Cheers for the heads up now. Please say she's caught me in clutch. No, she's just dipped. Nah, this
Boy,
is peak.
Have you guys got the drop on me?
That's one way to clear it out, I suppose. Such a cold move as well. Hold that.
Hey, Delson. Fire up that camera. I got something for the viewers at home.
Please. Please don't hurt me.
Hello, America. My name is Abigail Walker, but my friends and enemies call me Fetch. Two things you should know about me. One, I'm a Pisces. Two, I've never hurt an innocent person in my life. And that's still true. You may think I'm a monster, but it's not my fault. People who preach hatred of conduits leave us no choice. So who's really to blame here? Maybe you.
Oh. That was a nice touch at the end.
It just came to me.
Yeah?
About the part where I put a hole through the hater.
Ooh, golden age of television.
Oh, man. I got all this energy now. I gotta burn it off.
I mean, there's plenty of activists out
there.
You
want to hook up?
Activists can wait. Whoa. You want to go someplace where our bodies don't get riddled by bullets during foreplay?
Oh, foreplay's for the weak.
Target sighted! Up there!
What the fuck have they just thrown at me?
Bad move, man!
Oh, that's smoke.
This is gonna be awesome!
Unlucky.
Shit.
Lady, you are hell on bridges, you know that?
So you recognize me?
Oh, yeah. You're the one that had me dead to rights a couple weeks ago and just let me walk away?
You've changed since then.
You mean the smoke thing? Yeah, that's new.
I hear you've learned a new trick. You've expanded your arsenal.
Well, I don't know where you heard that. I mean, I'm just a lowly smoke guy.
We'll see.
Yeah, that's doing nothing for me.
Come on, you're so close. Stop running. No. Who won there? Oh, me. Thank fuck.
Oh, okay, so maybe I, lied about the neon thing, but... Listen, I think I can save us both a lot of time here. I just need to leech a little power off you, that's it.
You want me to just give you my power?
I mean, not enough to sink bridges or anything, but enough to pull the concrete daggers out of my friends, yeah. And then after that, you will never see me again.
I've got a better idea. Since you'd be useless to me back in your little hovel, how about you stay here with me?
I kind of like my idea better.
Dawson. You disappoint me. No.
Okay. Suckers.
Where the fuck did that chopper just come from?
Let's see, if I had one of these things on, I would want to get it off as fast as possible because they're butt ugly. And I guess because they just scream, attack me, I'm a suspected bioterrorist. So you want someplace private to get undressed with a door that locks, place to sit while you changed. A porta potty would be perfect. You'd kill two birds with one stone.
Which of you are hiding?
Hey, I'm not with the DUP, and I'm not a freak who goes around opening occupied porta potties.
You are there, mate. See you later. Oh, there's another guy like it as well.
Hey! No! No! God, after I climbed up all this way. Angel bastard should have let him fall. What?
What do you think? I mean, it's a little bit of pain putting on, especially in there. It's like somebody had some Thai food. But what do you think? Chase me.
You want me to chase you?
Yeah. Chase me, shoot me, shoot near me, and we'll see what happens when one of the angels shows up.
Yeah, because I've got a really good batting average with the angels right now. If they take you, man, they take you to God knows where.
I know. Okay, but look, you know how you're always losing your phone and then you grab mine and find it?
Right,
well, we have a GPS link.
So you're like a big, ugly tracking device. Okay.
Right, but look, we gotta make this look real, okay? Not too real, just real enough to fool the angels. Get me?
Oh, I can get you right between the eyes.
No, just don't be a dick.
Not bad.
Oh, worst idea ever. Oh, what the hell?
Woo, I gotta hand it to you, big brother. You make excellent live bait. Why, it worked, didn't it? Found the angel conduit slayer, now we go take him out. Come on, you come with me or what?
I'm gonna take this shit off. I'm gonna go cry myself to sleep. There's got to be a ton of weird, spiky shit down there, and that, brother, that's all you. Oh, my God.
Don't walk away mad. It was your plan.
What?
Let's go.
Don't hurt me, Nelson. At school, I always tried to blend in, to fade into the background, to disappear. But the bullies found me anyway. They always do. The only place I felt I belonged was in Heaven's Hellfire. In that game, I made the rules. I could summon angels to protect the victims and demons to punish the bullies. But the real world, that I couldn't control. At first, I did my best to ignore them. Until that one day. When they pushed me too far. When the DUP came, they said they were taking me to a new school, designed for people like me. Different. For 6 years, she hooked me up to her machines. And made me call them out, always was stopping before they could save me. Then that crash. That was my chance to finally really disappear. Where no one could find me and hurt me. But when I saw them rounding up more people who were different, I knew what she was gonna do to them. I knew we had to stop her.
Delson! Delson?
Okay, that's starting to get old.
It sounded like you were in trouble, so I came running. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. Thanks, man. I couldn't have done it without you. Oh, wait, I already did. Speaking of, man, you're not gonna believe what I can do now. As soon as I figure out what it is I can do.
What poor thing is you got a kidnapper off the streets?
Whoa, bro, not kidnapper. He's more like a rescuer.
Delson, listen to me. He took suspected conduits right off the street. Yeah. Against their will. That's kidnapping.
Okay, don't go anywhere. First of all, thank you for using the word conduit. Second of all, why are you being such a dick?
Look, fine. Let's just agree to disagree. But we both know it's better for everyone if he goes in a cage.
Just hang out for a second. Can I talk to you? I thought you were all about rule of law and not locking up people without due process.
Hey, normally, that's what I do.
Oh, what, so it just gets thrown out the window whenever it's convenient for you? Is that it? Just put a red wig and an old trench coat on, you start calling you Augustine.
Well, maybe next Halloween.
Cool, so Game Boy and I over there are gonna have a little conversation conduit to conduit. No normals allowed?
Fine. If you need me, be right outside.
Okay. Owen, thank you for all your help. Couldn't have done it without you. Oh, wait, I already did.
I know, it wasn't funny the first time.
So, Eugene. My brother, what do you say? You and me, a couple conduits, we hit the town, you teach me some of those video tricks, I teach you how to pick up girls, and we take our power to the people.
Well, I'd like to find the Russians that were picking on the suspected conduits and kicking the shit out of them for a change.
Dude, I want to party with you. It's a date then, yeah?
All right.
We will rise up, and we will teach them to accept us. Even if it kills them.
Gene, open up, it's me.
Hey, Delson.
What'd you move the clubhouse?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Let's rock and roll, man.
Well, no, you're gonna rock and roll. I'm gonna stick to the shadows.
What?
You know, stealth.
Right. Stealth. Funny how a little indiscriminate slaughter can make the whole world seem brighter, huh?
Hey, I made the world a better place. Figure I deserve a victory lap.
So, where are your friends? Nice exit.
We're like Banksy, but with superpowers. I've just noticed now I'm fully Infamous as well. My jacket's like, it changes every time that like, you level up an Infamous level. This looks cold. I got like the dead bird with like the flames behind it and it's all red. That's really cool.
Reg, what are you doing here?
Look, those are people over there. They need our help. Not bioterrorists, not conduits. People.
Well, thank you. And thank you for being here, so...
What's Cop doing here?
He's my brother, okay? He's here for me. So, what are you thinking?
I've been doing some recon. Our best bet's the dock on the far side. It's less exposed. Figure you two can do your smoke gift.
Thank
and
you.
Draw their attention out front. I'll commandeer your boat and go in during the distraction.
Why are you going in first?
Because I'm a cop. Which means I can commandeer a boat, and it's legal. You steal a boat, I'm gonna haul your ass in.
Oh, he'll do it, too. So we'll see you inside, right?
Yeah, see you inside. Stay safe, boy.
What? All of a sudden you don't trust me?
I don't know, man. Something's not right. Maybe I should call Reggie.
Hank!
Henry, you didn't disappoint me.
I did like you asked. You just do like you promised.
You son of a bitch! I trusted you!
Never trust a convict. I see we found something in your size, but just to be sure.
Oh, lady. My brother finds out what you did. Oh, he is gonna...
He's gonna what?
You could have hit me!
Yeah, that's payback for blasting me with the angels. Now, come on, get up. Come over here, I'll get those cuffs off you.
This way, I'll cover you.
Sorry, I'm out of grenades. You're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way.
What do you mean?
Put your hands up here. Don't flinch.
Stop!
Leave my brother alone, you bitch!
Oh, dear God!
Reggie!
Look at me. You gotta let me go.
No, I can do this.
Listen, we can't let this stuff get to you two. David, I'm so proud of you.
No.
Always have been.
No. Reggie, don't.
I love you, bro.
No!
Oh, shit. I was not expecting that after the whole campaign. Oh, shit. He's fully gone, isn't he? Unless it's going to be like what happened to the prisoner where he's, what they called, silenced. He's not actually dead, he's just in like the rock form thing.
Definitely felt that.
Wait, how did I fail? What happened there? What?
You tortured me!
Go on,
like
have
people.
A kick. Get out of here.
Damn you!
This is Kurt Wyatt reporting from the scene of an intense battle between the DUP and a small group of bioterrorists. You can see the last of the massive structure built by the DUP as it sinks into the icy waters of Puget Sound. Eyewitnesses tell us that the only survivor was DUP head Brooke Augustine, last spotted heading in the direction of the concrete tower that has served as our headquarters since the DUP arrival nearly 2 weeks ago. But so far, our efforts to reach Miss Augustine have produced no response. And now we're getting reports of scattered demonstrations by local citizens in
So I'm a bit confused there. Did we take her out or did she take us out and she's still alive? I'm a bit confused. Hopefully it's going to explain this.
I'm sorry, man. You knew. You told me not to trust Hank, but I didn't listen. But I swear to you, this son of a bitch is gonna take it.
Killed Reggie.
I didn't know. I swear to God.
You didn't know?
You set us up!
She said she wasn't gonna hurt you. She promised she's just gonna talk.
Wouldn't you believe her?
She got a sadistic streak a mile wide, but I never heard tell of her actually killing a conduit.
My brother would still be alive if it wasn't for you.
She had my daughter.
Motherfucker, really thought you, I was just gonna let him run away and live off the setting us up like that. No, thank you. So much. Oh no, he has done it. I was gonna say, what? Does my choice not even matter? I thought he'd fully about to fucking let him go then. Let's go do this.
Okay, I can work with that. Even if the rest of it is still active.
Hope you don't mind.
Hey, let's go. So I'm guessing from us helping Eugene and...
Happy to see
Fetch is their name.
Oh, I know.
They're both gonna help us out, hopefully.
So this means you're
alone. That'd be good.
You can, my.
Hey, Fetch, this would be a good time for some backup.
Ask and ye shall receive.
Hey, let's go. Eugene turned up as well.
Eugene.
Patton, see, so
sure know how to level the way
I may have chosen like, the evil way, but they've come to help us. So, Patton.
Any trouble finding the place?
I know all about what you did. Using Hank to set up the crash, making Eugene and Fetch look like monsters to scare the shit out of the city. Also, you could swoop in and be the hero.
I did what I had to protect conduits.
Protect? You hunt them down. You lock them up. And you train them to kill.
I needed Abigail and Eugene to be monsters, because without monsters, the monster hunters go out of business.
So that's what this is all about, huh? Job security?
And you almost derailed the whole operation. Luckily, you turned out to be the best thing that ever happened to me. You hear them out there? They want your. And once the world sees the head of the DUP saving them from the biggest bioterrorist threat of the last 7 years, your death will buy my DUP at least 20 more years of funding. I'm so glad we met when we did.
Don't be.
Oh. Oh, no. Are you gonna kill me now?
You're goddamn right I am.
And again, I have another one. Could talk about upgrading my blades before I come in here, because they seem to be doing the most power at the moment. There we go, and again, see you later. And now to do the dispatch thingy, let's go.
You want my power? You got it. Seven years ago, my unit was there to save lives from a new threat. Conduits. People with powers that no one understood. They had the power to kill. And the power to transform some of us into conduits, too. I found another survivor. She tailed me as I made my way back to the safety of my battalion. Together, we traveled through a lawless city that wanted us dead because of what we now were. Every day, people joined the lynch mob, horrified by the thought of conduits hiding among them. We'd hurt no one, but they could only see us as monsters. When military order finally asserted itself, they treated us as the threat. I was conduit. I was military. But I couldn't be both. So I made another option. It was the only way. By bringing in that first conduit alive, I'd earned the government's trust. And that was just the start. They funded the creation of the DUP, thinking we were just freaks hunting down other freaks. But that wasn't it. I was going to save as many conduits as I could. If my kind were going to live, it'd be behind the walls of Curtin K. Seven years, I've kept them safe. Me. I won't let anyone undo that. Not the government. Not the army. Not you.
7 years, all you've done is keep them locked up. You just took away their freedom.
So tell me, what would you do? Just throw open the gates at Curtin K Station? Set them all free?
You bet your ass I would.
The world hasn't changed in the past 7 years. Inside, the conduits are safe. They're alive. You turn them out, they'd all be dead inside a week. So tell me, who's the savior? And who's the monster?
This is what you wanted! You win! We both have the same power! Only difference is, I've had 7 years to practice.
Thank fuck for that. That's been an extremely long boss battle. I've died way too many times. And the fact you start off with no abilities because of the fact that she's just giving you the power. Like, it's peak. Brilliant game. Yeah. Stressful boss battle there.
That hurts. Augustine had come to Seattle with a plan. To spread fear, panic, chaos. Make herself out to be a hero. Her plan was soon shattered by monsters she had made. Fetch, Eugene, and me. For 2 weeks, Augustine had controlled Seattle. Now it was our turn. Who the hell was gonna stop us? Oh, and the hundreds of conduits Augustine had locked away at Curtin K Station? I'm gonna shake each and every one of their hands on their way out the door. So many different powers, all in one place. I'll be the kid in the candy store. But first, I had a promise to take care of.
Snokomish Nation. Local heroes back home. There's my girl. Whoa, slow down. What? Come back to save the day.
The TV news showed everything. It showed everything.
Okay, look, about
I saw you kill dozens of innocent people.
What did you want me to do? Okay, I wasn't gonna let anybody or anything stop me from getting back to you. To save everybody. We're a Komish. We take care of our own, right? Hey, take it easy.
You have disgraced our people. You have disgraced our ancestors. And you have disgraced the memory of your brother. You are a Komish no longer.
You, everybody else, will die without me. Or have you forgotten that?
We haven't forgotten. And we will never forget.
Shit, well, she is not happy with us. Oh shit, did he just take out their whole little community there? Because I know what that ability does. Holy shit. If there's a bonus cutscene, I will cut to it. Obviously, I don't want to get copyrighted for this, so I'll be back once this has ended. Sadly, there was no bonus cutscene. Sorry, I had to like do a quick cut there. It went straight into the end credits and the music was so loud I didn't want to get copyrighted for it. But I hope you have enjoyed the infamous Second Son bloopers and best moments. If you have, be sure to hit the like button. Also consider subscribing, so we've got one more game in the series and I've got plenty more content planned throughout the year. And I'll see you in the next infamous game. Peace.